hit the same target, Erland. Two arrows in its breast. You must have been born under cancer. Look. Wait here. I'll try to drive him towards you.
Jake, Grip, come.
I'm not afraid of you.
How beautiful you are. Your name? You're not from this country.
No. Not from this country or any other.
Where are you from?
From nowhere and everywhere. I'm just passing.
Do you know whom you're talking to? I'm Erland, heir to the Monashals. All this country is mine.
That's not much. I'd smother in your place. I own the entire world. And the wind is my servant. It takes me wherever I wish to go.
Never where it wishes to go?
It's the same thing. That was all my desires.
Your desires? That sounds more like a lover than a servant.
Whoever loves me serves me. Yes. Yes, you are right. The wind is my lover. Blood. My name is Singoalla. No. Farewell, my knight.
When will you return?
Ask the wind.
A good marriage, conjugal love, affection, might help him dispel these strange forces.
I know, but it is not only a question of Erland's illness, Reverend Father, but the curse on the family name. Remember that Bengt, my husband, died at 25. And Hugo, my father-in-law, was only 23. Sigurd, Erland's great-grandfather, was 26. This is truly the widow's castle. Should Erland die, the name would die with him. I have decided to marry him to Sir Gudmund Olfsax's daughter. The trouble is that the mere mention of marriage sends him into the depths of depression. Strange. He's laughing. Usually nightfall saddens him.
What are you thinking about?
I wasn't thinking of anything, sir. Really? Run along then.
Oh, what a beautiful night. On a night like this, the stars could only predict happiness. Don't you agree, Reverend Father?
You're quite right, my son. Great happiness indeed.
Really?
Yes. A meeting.
A meeting?
With a young girl.
Incredible.
Why?
Incredible. And, this young girl, will she love me?
Passionately, my son. I know that the idea of marriage is not particularly attractive to you, but...
Not attractive to me? Consult your stars again, Reverend Father.
Maybe you'll think I'm presumptuous, but for the sake of our old friendship, I know you'll forgive me if I...
Leave me alone!
She'll never return. It's as though you had met her in a dream, as though she had never existed.
I know she'll return.
Helena Olfsacks is very beautiful. I'd marry her myself just to do you a favor. Though I doubt she'd consent.
You idiot.
You might at least come down and pay your compliments to the bride I've chosen for you.
A good choice. She's so beautiful. And virtuous, too. Even in her dreams, no doubt. And her father is a wealthy and powerful baron. Why shouldn't I be the happiest of men? But I don't love her.
Oh, so you're asking for love, too. You are not master of your own fate. Remember, you are a monoshot. That's all that matters.
Very well, then.
Listen to me, my child. Your father never really loved me. Yet we learned to live without happiness.
And the outcome?
I don't rightly know. He died so young. Thank you. for each other, Baron.
Same as our lands, Duchess. A powerful union.
You know our parents plan to marry us, don't you? You are so beautiful. Your eyes are as gentle as a dove's. A pity, black is so unbecoming to one of your years.
Black?
Widow's weeds. Look at them. All three. Has no one warned you of the Mornichal's curse? Widowhood is quite premature. Although I must confess you'd make a ravishing widow.
How cruel you are, Erland.
A terrible pall, Elaine. A pall lies over this castle.
Couldn't I help? I'm not afraid. Even the sign of the cross from a child will ward off any devil. Why couldn't I obliterate the curse with...
love?
Appealing to your mercy. You may read in these hands the marks of suffering.
I only read dishonesty in your face. What do you wish?
Having heard of your bounty, permit a band of tired wretches to camp a few days in your forest.
Indeed. The reputation which has preceded you does not allow me to grant you your wish. Leave at once.
Mother!
Yes?
How can you tolerate wild beasts on your lands and yet deny shelter to the needy?
The needy?
I appreciate your mistrusting them, yet I cannot but feel that Erland is right. Couldn't you grant him his wish tonight?
Be it so.
You may stay.
Ah, God bless your grace. You will never regret it.
Most beautiful of all.
Like the moon?
Yes.
Thank you.
finally come back. I've known the whole time that you would return to me. Your image has been constantly with me. I've wondered so where you were.
I lived in a sort of nightmare, a world of shadows, where the sun never shone. There was no day anymore.
Oh, strange. Hearing you speak, I almost believe I'm saying those words. There's been no day for me either. A pale, joyless light. Hours.
Which never ended.
When I saw the snow falling, I thought of you shivering. And when the cold wind touched my lips, I thought of yours that might be cold.
When I heard the wild animals cry the night, I thought of you lying wounded in the forest.
But when the ice began to melt, I knew you would be coming back. The first flowers told me of your approach. And finally, the birds sang that you were here. How I prayed for the spring.
Spring. But you are the spring. You are the only living thing in the world. Only you. It's dark already, my love. I have to leave you now.
Leave? Why?
Well, I'm only a wanderer. And you are rich and secure. You own all this. And you love me. Oh, if this is a dream, don't ever wake me up.
Remember when you told me you owned the world? Now I own much, much more.
You must have been born under the same star.
No, don't talk about the stars.
Why not?
Mine is not a lucky one.
Oh, don't do that. It's magic. Don't laugh. You mustn't ever tempt fate. Look. This means sorrow.
And this means joy.
Terribly jealous.
My mother wishes me to marry this girl. But I don't want to.
My father, too, wants me to marry a man that I don't love. I'd rather die. Can you hear them sing? I have to go now.
What do you want?
It's getting dark.
Can I help it?
Your daughter has disappeared since dawn. Don't you think that's strange?
Mind your own business.
It is my business, since my son's going to marry her.
No crow.
Huh?
Come.
Listen. The castle chapel has some very interesting items. Maybe a little casual visit. And then...
I'll follow you. Wherever you go, I'll go. You shall be my wife.
Your wife?
Yes.
Thank you.
won't regret your coming with me.
Regret the castle of sorrows? All I want is to live with you with the whole wide world as our home.
Unto death.
Unto death, Singoalla.
I swear I will love Alan unto death and be true to him. Should I betray him, he has the right to kill me. And he, as God, shall deny me paradise. Now you must swear by the stone of Alarko, the god of our tribe.
I swear I will love Singoalla unto death and be true to her. If I should betray her, she has a right to kill me, and her god shall deny me paradise.
You're as one now.
You, put it down there. And you, stay close by the wagon and keep your eyes open.
She's waiting for Ella.
What an honor to the chief to have a nobleman for a son-in-law.
Well, if he's so anxious to be my son-in-law, he can run after us. Hurry!
Hurry! Stop the wagon!
Start the wagon, I said!